Here, at Armor Holdings in Los Angeles, they manufacture some of the most sophisticated armor ever developed. The challenge, create a garment capable of stopping bullets, but lightweight enough to allow for full, unrestricted movement. As company director Tim Smith explains, it's all about the materials.
There's a number of materials that we use in developing soft body armor, and each of them have desirable characteristics.
Modern lightweight body armor was first developed with Kevlar, a fabric invented to replace steel belts in car tires. Now, other ballistic fabrics such as Spectra and Dyneema are also used. Pound for pound, they are an incredible 5 times stronger than steel, thanks to their special type of weave.
One of the things that you want to do is be able to dissipate energy. So if it's held like this and you impact the side of it with a projectile, it has to propagate energy quickly up and down the length.
In effect, the material works like a trampoline, spreading the bullet's impact out over a wide area. So rather than slice through the fabric, its energy is dispersed. But that's not enough. To prevent serious damage from happening, you need something more. So modern armor uses 4 different layers of fabric, each with slightly different properties. The man in charge of testing and studying the effects of gunshots on these materials is ballistics expert Bruce Weber.
Here's a common woven material, and you notice it's a very coarse weave here. And we put that weave out front.
This first layer uses heat-resistant synthetic fibers called aramids. These fibers are designed to stretch like spider silk, slowing the bullet down.
Back here is a material from Russia. It's known as Autex. If you notice, it's a real tight, fine weave.
The tightly woven Artex slows the bullet further by dissipating its energy.
We've coupled it with a non-woven material, a polyethylene.
These various layers don't just slow the bullet down, they also flatten its nose, reducing its ability to slice through the final layer.
Each one of these materials has some strengths and weaknesses.